Here it is, our 2019 Jeep Wrangler Sport. And today, she's getting upgraded to a 2022 Jeep Wrangler Rubicon. Let me take a quick look at the driver's cluster here. And the center dash, which is filthy, but as you can see down there, there's a port for charging, a window, controls, a cigarette lighter, a little glove stash there, and of course the controls with the little screen for the radio, the heat, everything else. We had these here seat covers put on when we bought the Jeep, and I have to say they've done pretty good for us in protecting the material. They've been a good little addition. The center console, we've got a stick over here for shifting from 2 to 4, low and high. That's our automatic transmission shift. 2 cup holders, that's for the key, but you can also set your phone in there. And the center console here opens up, it's got a nice deep pocket. It's got a shallow pocket where we keep some small things like that's a discount gas card. In the back of the seat here, you can see it's got a nice pocket on the seat cover. And in the center dash here, we have 2 cup holders. And there's no charging ports back here. There's window controls and the heat vents. Oh, inside the center dash, there's also 1 USB port. C, I think. I'd have to check. And on the back seat, this is also covered. And there's no center armrest or console on the Sport Wrangler. It's got a headrest in the center. The seat comes forward so you can put things in. I put in a rod holder set. This came with our Jeep. It was an addition, or yeah, in addition to the Jeep. It's a Thule rack with the Jeep name on it. Of course, the back of our Jeep. And she's got the Jeep tire cover, spare tire. It's a full-size spare. So it just comes with a fifth wheel, basically. So the Jeep Sport Wrangler does not come with LED lights all the way around. It comes with regular halogens. Of course, the badge on the back here gives you some additional information, where it was built and whatnot, which is pretty cool. And in the back here, got some tethers on the seat that can be used to tether things down. The floor also has tethers on either side. We got the plastic cargo mat, or rubber cargo mat. And of course, the Jeep frame, that's there, the roll bars to keep you safe. And this here, down here, is a cover for the T-bar roof at the front. When we take it out, they go inside of there. So then, under this mat, we've got the carpet. This pulls up, and it's got this well. I use it for storing the cargo net for the roof rack and Jeep manuals, tape measure, a few other little knickknacks. Back here, this here, as you can see, it says door hinges. So this is where you would put the screws when you took them out from removing the doors. Your roof screws go here, and windshield screws go here, so you can keep them organized. And this is the lug for removing the tire. This here will lift up. It's hinged, it lifts up. And inside there is the actual jack for the Jeep, so you can do a tire change if you had to. There we go. Of course, my fishing rod's laying out in the back, not up in the rack right now. I do that sometimes. Overall, she's been a great Jeep. 3.5 years. We've waited 8 months for the Rubicon to come. And so this has been our go-to ride since we moved into the house, basically. And it's been wonderful. It's got good power for a 2-liter engine. Oh yeah, not much difference in the body design from the 2019 to the 2022. We ordered it, the Rubicon, we ordered it back in April. And it's December 24th, it's finally here and we're going to get it. I'm really excited about it. It's I guess it's like my Christmas gift. And the beauty of it is this Jeep, Jeeps in general, the Wranglers, they hold their value. And with this trade-in that we're doing today, it's going to save me 20% of my monthly loan cost. Even though the Jeep Rubicon is a much more expensive vehicle, this Jeep has a lot of value still left in it. So it actually gets back more than what we owe on the loan itself. So that is applied to our new Rubicon, and it's going to save me about $100 a month or 10,000 yen a month, which is a huge amount of money, especially with the way prices and inflation and things are going today in the economy. Anyway, so that's it for this Jeep. We're going to get her out and we'll get the new Rubicon and we'll get a video on that and we'll do a little side by side. Okay, everyone, here we are. Welcome back, and today it's Christmas Day, so Merry Christmas, everybody. And just about to show you the big Christmas gift that I've been waiting for the last 8 months, and it actually came yesterday, but we got home a little bit late, so I couldn't do this video to finish it up. And here I am today. So here we go, introducing our 2022 Jeep Rubicon, and she's a beauty. As you can see, the front has vents for each continent on the planet. It's got the LED lights. All the lights are LED on this here. And there's not much difference between this and our Sport in the front here, except the headlight package behind the grill there. The honeycombing is a little bit different. But the bumper is pretty much the same, maybe a little bit tighter. But man, she looks so pretty. Let's take a look down the driver's side here. So here we go. And there it is. The Rubicon emblem on the hood. And I'll go around the outside and then we'll come back up to the front here. So as we go down, we opted in for the stubby antenna here. We have the whip at home, but we wanted to have the stubby because it doesn't get stuck into so many branches and stuff. So going down, we have, these are custom. The rock rails are at home, and these side steps are custom, an add-on feature. And we'll go around the whole vehicle here. As you can see, we have rain gutters on our windows, and the rain gutters actually say Jeep. So they're an official Jeep rain gutter. And the tire package is a little different. I think these are about 1 inch taller than the Sport. And you can see it has a lot of clearance, a lot of clearance. It's a really beautiful design. And if you look here, as always, the iconic Jeep is displayed in quite a few different places on the vehicle. And that will come around the back here. So at the back, we just went with the standard soft shell tire cover with just Jeep on it. We were gonna get one that has a parachute, the one that goes with the Willys, but we opted to stay away from that. The vehicle looks a little bit wider than the Sport in 2019. The roof rack is, well, it's the roof rack just transferred from the other one over to this. And you can see it's got a tow bar here. So if you get stuck and you need to get hauled out, you can get that winched on there and then just get pulled out. And again, the package comes with the all-around LED lighting. They're really pretty. When they light up at night, they look gorgeous. Yeah, we'll come around this side. Another feature that is on this that was not on the Wrangler, the fuel cap lid here. So this is just a flap to hide that. And it's a key lock, of course, like the other one. So it's not really a security feature here. The security feature is on the cap itself, but it's a nice piece of trim that makes it look really clean and beautiful. Of course, we take a look at the roof rack. We haven't looked at this before, but you can see it says Jeep on it here. And of course, this has the Jeep emblem on it. And we'll take a look up the top here. It also says Jeep, it does that all the way around. What this is a Thule set, a Thule system. And this rack is really nice. And we have a net in the cargo area at the back that goes over this. We can just load it up and put the net on. We don't have to strap it down, but I do have straps for it so that we can lash things down. But we don't actually need it with that net on. So let's go back out again. And we'll go back up towards the front here. And I just want to take a look here at the side quickly. As you can see, it says Rubicon, Jeep Wrangler Unlimited, and the badge, trail rated badge. So the Rubicon is trail rated, and I guess this here is kind of famous for doing the Rubicon. Got some nice vents here for cooling. Really nice system all around. If you look at the top of the hood here, it's also got these nice same vents on it. So what we've gone with this time is a camera setup on the front. This comes with it. This is a standard option. So you get the forward view. And we'll take a look at the engine, as all Jeeps. It's just a push down and pop the latch. And then go into the center. And hoist it up. Grab this. And once that's pulled down, you just pop it into the allotted slot over here for it. So this Jeep has a 2.0 liter Huracan engine. It's from an Alfa Romeo. It's a turbo, and it has quite a lot. I think it's got 278 foot-pounds of torque. I'm probably wrong on that, but it's around there. It's actually has more foot-pound torque than a six-cylinder Sahara. So, and she's better on gas. So, got the major electrical system in it. And she's a really beautiful, tight little engine. Runs well. Just set it back down like that. mirrors down, pull up, push down, pull up, and you're set. Let's take a look at the driver's side. So we'll go to the interior here. You can see the interior is really nice. Start at the door. We got the mirror adjustment, door locks, nice little, it's plastic, but it looks nice. It's metallic looking. And the black kind of leathery interior here with the red stitching that matches the Rubicon logo and the badge on the other side. And if you look through the chairs, the strap for pulling the seat forward, and it also has the red stitching all the way around, and it has the Rubicon stitching in the center of the seat. Really beautiful. And we look at the steering wheel here. The steering wheel has it's a typical steering wheel, but this one has the chrome looking steering wheel cluster controls, and it's a beautiful little setup. You can control everything, your phone volume on your stereo. You can do cruise control, everything from here. So the cluster itself is really nice, and it is set up in the center here with the larger screen than the Sahara Wrangler Sport. And that screen just gives you a little bit more viewing area, but this here also comes with its own navigation system in it. And the navigation system can be set up just to use on this panel here, or it shows up in the center cluster. As you see right in here, it would show up in there. And we'll take a look at that. So we have everything set right now. You can see it has the black dash, black panels with the red accents across the dashboard all the way across. And it looks really pretty. It has an analog and a digital display and RPMs. Down here, the biggest difference is this here was all the way across. You could put an iPhone in there before, but now because of it being Rubicon, as you can see, it has the off-road sway bar connector and disconnector. And it has front and rear controls, and of course the shift here from two high to four high auto to four high part-time, neutral, and four low, which you would use on steep inclines. It has an 8-speed transmission, I believe it is. So you can go park, reverse, neutral, drive, then you can go over and you can actually use it like a Sportronic shifter. And again, you can see all the stitching and all the beautiful stitching on all the seats, and the center console follows through and along the dash up here. And she's really, really beautiful. Has a dual, so shallow tank. We put cards in here for gas deductions and stuff. And it has a deeper one. And inside here, there's a USB charge down here. And we'll close that. As you can see, this has the USB and C and auxiliary plus window controls, lock for the back, cigarette lighter, and some other controls. You can control the seats have heat, so you can push this button here and you can heat your seats. It's got steering wheel heater control on the top there. You can get the anti-slip on. You can mute everything with one button. So it's pretty cool. Of course, it comes with standard Jeep safety package. In the back, as you can see, we have an optional mesh to keep our dogs in the back cargo area when we're traveling with them long distance. or anywhere, for that matter, just to keep them safe from flying up to the front, and also to keep them from jumping over the seat. You can see the red stitching continues as the front all the way through. We got three seats here with the center, and the center console here, pull this button, folds out, becomes an armrest and drink holder, and a place to put your iPhone. Pretty snazzy. And the doors, again, the chrome lock, the stitching, all black with the net bag on the side for storage. The backs of the seat are different. So our other one, the Sport, we had covers on it, and you saw there was just a little pocket down here. That was a seat cover to protect. These are leather seats, and they have a plastic back with molly straps and small little net for holding different things, iPads, small little items that you might want to put in there. The center cluster has got the heater. Another difference for this here is down here. As you can see, we've got window controls, but then we've got USB and C, and then we've got a regular outlet for electric, for charging small things, probably like PCs and whatnot. And a storage place where you can put iPhones. And then down here, a little place where you can put probably small change or just small little items, keys or something that you don't want to have rolling around. Again, at the back on the tire, we have a standard reverse camera. And then we'll go in here. And there it is, you can see. It's got the Jeep plaque on it here. Shows different specifications of the Jeep. Shows where it was made in the USA. This one was made in Auburn Hills, Michigan. And developed in Auburn and built in Toledo, Ohio. So that's where this one comes from. We have a secondary camera package up here. And actually, if you look at the front up there, one second, that up there is the same thing for the front. So now we can record our travels, and one of the new big differences also with the Rubicon, there's the Alpine subwoofer system. So this, I believe, has a 6.1 speaker surround. This is the bag to put the T's in, the T-top, when you take off the front tops. And of course, I wouldn't be anybody if I didn't have a fishing rod in here, would I? Now, again, we've got the storage, and again, it's the same thing. That's our locking lug for our tires, and you push that button and this whole unit will lift, and underneath of here is the jack. So we use this for storage, but this could be filled with ice, and you can put cold drinks inside there, and it has a drain in the bottom, so it's like a cooler if you want. You can put anything that you want to keep cool. With a bunch of ice in there, empty it out, just throw ice in, throw whatever you want. Then when you finish, you just pull the plug and she drains out. So you could have some tailgaters, not in Japan you can't, but in other places you can. And of course, the manual that comes with the Jeep, this one's in Japanese, but they ordered me the English version of it, and the standard tool set that comes for Jeep for taking off the windows, doors, and the back window, the back door, and also taking off the top cab roof. You have to undo some of the bolts back here as well. And ever so important part of having a Jeep is having that freedom. It makes you feel like you have some freedom. We've got these optional mats put in. This is flipped upside down, so it gives it the carpet look, right? There's the dog mesh. It just goes onto these lashes that lashing spots that we use for holding down cargo. It was underneath there and up on the top and around. It's a really nice addition to this car, to this truck, sorry. Also, we got this cigarette lighter adapter, so if we want to plug something in here, like to charge it, we can put an adapter in here. And of course, when you take off the back window, you've got all the electronics hooked up. And if you take off the top and the back window here, you need to reconnect the wires. So you got this wiring box down here, and you just disconnect and reconnect into that so that you have your lights operational at the back. We also got these optional LEDs put in, and that's the standard. But this here is incredible. This helps out quite a lot. If you look over here, same thing. And you'd be surprised, we tried them out last night and it lights this area up unbelievably. That's my fishing rod straps. They go up on top across the roll bars here and in between those front doors and the back doors, and then I can hang my fishing rod up on that set. So they come with the Jeep all-terrain rubber wheel well protectors, and they have drains in them so that any water gets in, it'll drain right out. And another thing we got, these optional hand grips to help you get in and out, give you an extra security spot to hold on to if you're off-roading as well, as of course the standard grip areas. And then, of course, the camera that's at the front, all of the mirrors on the car, all of the mirrors are dimmable. That's the front, that's in front of us, clean camera and rear glass, so a clean camera. And then that's the rear, so that's how we see when we're backing up, if we want to do that. And then we've got a side door camera that comes off the side of the passenger door, so that when you're edging along, you can see pretty much directly down. Look, you can even see the footstep, the side step here, the side rail. So it's pretty good. We get a good, pretty good view of it, where the camera's under the mirror here. So the camera is right under here. You can see my hand in it. Right, and it gives a really nice view of everything around. So that's that. It's got all your applies that you possibly want. There's an app manager you can go in, upload. You can put in updated information for the navigation system. What else we got here? Go back into apps. So of course in the apps, off-road pages, projection manager, there's the heated wheel, climate control for the heated, the heat ducts, where you want it to come out the floor, the window, or the dashboard. And you can turn the screen off and on. The mirror dimmer, your media, which is your AM, FM, and television. I'll show you that in a sec. Then we got other controls over here, like the iPhone is on. So that's it. I don't think there's anything else. So, of course, we've got the ETC system. In Japan, you have to have an ETC card to ride on the highway. Everything's pay as you go. It's nice and deep. I can get my arm down pretty far in there. I'd say that's a good 20 centimeters deep pocket. Okay. So FM on the media, we have FM, AM. We got the source select down here, and if I go to DTV, then I get one channel of television and expand that out to be full. And yeah, so that's a tour of our 2022 Jeep Rubicon and a look at our 2019 Jeep Wrangler Sport. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please remember to hit the subscribe, like, and share button. I don't know what my next video will be, but I'm looking forward to seeing y'all here in the new year. Happy New Year 2023. See you soon.